Hi, everyone. It's back to the World Series of Poker, where Romain Lewis has once again made it to the money. But our hero is aiming much higher in this $3,000 buy-in 6-max tournament, as he accumulated a stack of $1.3 million on day one. Going into day two, Romain is in 11th place out of 41 players still in the field. Come on, Romain. It's time to be ambitious.
We're having a really great time at the villa at the moment. There's so many good vibes. Alex won a bracelet. I mean, everyone's on good form. The pool is hot. We're playing some basketball. We got some pool. We've even got table tennis in the garage, so no, it's a really good time to be in Vegas. 25, 28 degrees during the day. October, November is just much nicer than July and June with a 45 degree baking hot. WSOP day two. Let's go.
Hello, Hello coach.
Ça va?
Ça va et toi?
Ça va.
Tranquille. Hot up, hot up, hot up, hot up.
There you go. Hop. Mes GPS auquel je me souviens plus comment
avec
on
le petit paillade devant. C'est pas mal.
Ah bah oui, c'est pas, c'était pas volontaire en plus.
Bonjour.
Mais c'est, ah ouais, non. Donc là, t'es là pour l'instant. Et c'est là qu'on va.
Exactement. Juste là, à droite.
Magnifique. Et allez. Bon, t'as eu le site draw.
J'ai eu le site draw.
Pas trouvé d'infos sur le premier mec.
Ouais. Au bataillon. J'ai l'impression que c'était quasiment ma table de hier soir. Je suis pas sûr qu'il y a eu un redraw complet. J'ai l'impression que ça. Enfin, je connaissais pas les noms des joueurs à ma table, mais j'avais le chip leader juste à ma droite, j'avais plus ou moins la même config, donc ça se trouve, ils ont pas changé.
Ok.
Ils vont faire redraw 24 ou sûrement un truc comme ça. Mais bon, ça fait plaisir ça.
Bon, bien, alors raconte.
J'ai joué des mains non GTO, on va dire, pour chauffer un peu une table où il y avait 4 amateurs et Mata Simolas, un bon pote que je connais bien, qui allait pas trop. Et ça. Ça a bien fonctionné quoi, j'ai juste montré une main complètement pourrie sur un 3-bet et derrière le mec il m'a donné quelque chose comme 60-70 blindes avec deux paires sur As-Roi Dame Valet où il a déjà mal à terre dans le protect quand j'ai carte genre pour monter. Ouais, donc vraiment belle.
Bien.
Et non, après c'était une longue journée, je ressentais un peu de fatigue, donc du coup je gérais un peu entre essayer d'être présent à table, puis mettre un peu de musique et me remettre dans ma bulle un peu et pas trop discuter avec les autres. Ça prend beaucoup d'énergie et beaucoup d'action, beaucoup de gens excités en 6 max quoi. Ils veulent de l'action, ils ont tant d'action dans les paroles que dans le jeu. Donc j'étais un peu on-off dans ce sens-là, mais dans le jeu je me suis trouvé.
C'est bien, hein, c'est la bonne façon de fonctionner, hein, on en avait parlé de ça. Hein, concentré, relâcher quoi. Tu vois, focus quand tu joues et puis. Arriver à récupérer, charger les batteries entre les deux, parce qu'effectivement c'est long dans les journées. Hein.
Ouais, c'est clair. Et non, j'ai eu de la chance avec mes tirages de table. En soi, j'ai eu des bonnes tables et il me laissait bien tranquille à la bulle. J'avais même pas obligé de shove des gros montants à prendre un peu des risques et pas savoir ce qu'ils allaient coller. Je faisais des petits min raise ou je faisais des petits 2.5 kicks, je prenais pas non plus trop de risques.
C'est top.
Et non, ouais, quelques rides qui sont bien passées. Non, super journée, je suis assez content. Ouais. Je suis assez content de ma journée.
Bon, alors aujourd'hui, qui est donc le dernier jour du tournoi.
C'est ça, ça va jusqu'au bout.
Ça va jusqu'au bout, on est d'accord là-dessus. Hein.
Bah, c'est ce qu'ils ont écrit après.
Et selon les calculs, non, mais ça va aller vite, hein, ce qu'on essaie de calculer justement et tout ça, mais ça va finir ce soir, c'est sûr. Hein.
Ah ouais, ok. Ouais.
On estime que, tu vois, Aurélie, elle disait 19h30, 19h15, 15 left, je pense qu'il y aura moins que ça même à 19h15.
Ouais,
ça va méga vite. Hein.
Ouais, c'est possible.
Donc en tout cas, ce qui est sûr, c'est qu'il faut être prêt à aller jusqu'au bout aujourd'hui.
Ah bah ça finira pas demain. Après, bien chaud, bien motivé, surtout après une journée comme ça, c'était vraiment full bonne zone, des bons feelings du début à la fin, ouais, vraiment. C'est un des premiers tournois qui a fait plus de runners qu'en 2019, une 3K6 max.
Ah ouais?
Ouais, c'est marrant ça.
Mais il existait ce tournoi avec cette structure-là? Ils ont changé la structure quoi.
Je pense qu'il y avait moins de niveau de blinde et que c'était une heure de niveau quoi.
Ouais, c'est ça, et du coup il devait durer 3 jours au lieu de 2 à mon avis.
Ouais, ça c'est sûr.
Pour ton t-shirt et tout, si jamais tu as un t-shirt.
Il fait tellement froid dans Amazon.
Alright man.
Cheers,
good luck. Let's do it.
Yep, soyez.
Ciao, ciao.
Ciao, ciao.
All right, feeling good, the sun is out. But I'm going inside in the darkness. 40, 42 players left. Great feeling here. Walking up the stairs, going through the doors, into the long corridor and up to the Amazon room. It's where all the magic happens at the WSOP, and we love it here. But first we got a stop for Alex's bracelet ceremony, the first French bracelet ceremony of the year. We've got a few friends here, a lot of playing ready, but we'll go in, have a sing-song. La Marseillaise is one of my favourite hymns, so I'd like to sing it with friends and be there for my buddy. He's really one of the guys I started poker with 5-6 years ago. It was really great to talk with him about strategy all the time, and now seeing him win his first bracelet is really motivating. I really want to win mine now. But this is his moment. Let's sing for him.
Today, we have our first French winner of the 2000.
I'm with Aurélie. Aurélie's wife that I know really well as well. Great poker player she is, Julien and John. It's a big moment for him, it's a big moment.
Thank you.
Gregory Chauchon, please join me in this very, very special moment today, because France has not been winning enough bracelets at this WSOP record. And so I would like for Greg to do these honors today. So Greg, would you please?
Merci. Merci, Greg. Thank you.
National Français, Les Marseillais, the national anthem of France.
Alex, yes, what a moment. So powerful. Everyone's so happy for him, and now it's time to focus, concentrate on what's important for me is to be in that situation myself. It's to be able to sing that French anthem with my buddies and put maybe a second bracelet up for Team France this year. That would be unbelievable.
Hi there. Hi, man. How you doing? Hi. All good.
But it all starts now. 42 players. There's not going to be so many situations this summer that I'm going to be in this spot. So, I mean, it's not now or never, but this is a great opportunity and I'm here to take it. Come on, poker gods. Come on, Rom. Keep the close, cold-headed mind. All I need is for myself to be in the moment, take the good decisions, a few good cards, and I could be celebrating with Alex in a few days. Come on, let's go. folded all the way around here. It's the first hand of the day. I got the big blind and looking down 10-4 suited. Just an easy hand to see a flop with. Don't really want to get the pot gloated too much yet. All right, ace-6-6. Interesting. If he checks, I'll probably go for a bet. He's gone for a really quick bet here, and it just seems like it's that continuation bet with any sort of hands. The fact that there are two sixes here means that he probably wouldn't bet an ace all the time, and I've got so many sixes that could have just checked back that I'm going to use that in my favor to start bluffing here. I've got backdoor flush draw, and I just think a raise is pretty good. It should get through, yeah. Okay, brilliant. Got the first blind and blind. Important start to the day, come on. Everyone's kind of got the same sort of stack here. I mean, it's really quite shallow. 40, 50 blinds in this tournament is huge. I'm feeling comfortable, but every pot is really important. It's folded the way around again to the small blind. We played this blind on blind last time. Now I'm looking at 10-9 suited. I mean, really nice hand here. I could raise, but I think I'll be putting myself against two strong holdings if I raise. So I prefer to keep all his hands in and dominate quite a few 10 highs, 9 highs. I can play a lot of boards with this sort of hand. It's exciting. Okay, that's a good flop for me. 7-8-4, and he doesn't look interested or too interested. He's just paying money for his bottle of water or something really quickly. So I think I'm going to go for a bet here. The question is, what sizing? I think I could go quite expensive straight away. I'm going to go for nearly pot size bet. Put some pressure on. I mean, the way he's acting, I can't believe he has like a flop straight or a really strong hand. But he's actually called the pot size bet really quickly, so seems like he has a bit of something. The turn is an 8, and just the way he checked, called that flop, it doesn't look like he had an 8 top pair that often. It looks like he was more often like maybe an ace-6, ace-5, a sort of weak 7, a 4. I think I'm going to go for another bet. The thing is here, he could have also overcards and flush draws. He could call this big bet with spade draws, with heart draws, with 7. So if I go big here, I'm probably have to go on the river again if he calls, but hopefully this just goes well and he can fold straight away. Okay, it doesn't look like he's going away. Okay. He's gone for quite a quick call again. I mean, I'm pretty sure he doesn't have an 8. He would have played an 8 differently. So if two flush draws blank now, and wow, they have. All right, the two flush draws have blanked. I don't block any of the flush draws. I got 10 high, and I've got a lot of eights that could play this way. I have 5-6. I think I have to continue bluffing with this hand now. The question is, what sizing? All in, I mean, just thinking of all in here just makes my pots go too quickly. I think a third pot isn't that bad because he's just gonna fold flush draws against a third, and he could even fold a 7. I mean, I could value bet a lot of hands a third here, and it impact me too much for a pot size bet to go away. I think I have to bluff this holding. Gonna go for a third. And oh wow, he's just snap called me. Oh my god, no. Doesn't even wait for it. A7, probably unfoldable. I mean, I'm probably that sizing I could value. Queen 7, Jack 7, but oh wow, that's a big portion of my stack gone really quickly. Not even 3 seconds of tank. He just snapped me off there and what have I got left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow, that's changed my tournament a lot now. A rough start to the day. Wow, I looked out of pocket 7s the hand after. I mean, am I gonna go all in here? What have I got? I've been feeling about 23 blinds. I mean, at the end of the day, it's small blind against hijack, 23 blinds. God, it would be absolutely terrible to get snapped off here and just play three hands in my day two. But I think, what am I going to do? I can call in the small blind and play out of position, but there's already a lot out there. And I can get a lot of hands, of course, from the hijack to fold. And if he has just eights, nines or better, I mean, what can I do? I think I've got to put it all in here. I hate it, but.
All in.
Okay, he hasn't snap called me. That's the greatest thing. Because it's an easy snap call with nines or better, so at least now, probably flipping. If he calls me with pocket sixes, that would be insane. Okay, folds it, gives it up, that's good news. Did not want to play a race there. We're still in the game now, come on. Table breaking, nothing much I could do after that hand. I mean, the 9-10 is still really in my head. I mean, maybe I shouldn't bluff the river, but I definitely shouldn't think about that hand for too long. But it's turning in my head, and this is the hard bit about emotions and going deep in tournaments, is keeping my brain and everything I'm thinking about for the moment. This is the most important thing. I'm not thinking about the past, I'm not thinking about what can be. But thinking about the next hand, that's what's the most important thing is going to be. But it is tough sometimes. It's mentally tough, this game. But I'm trained. I know what I'm here to do. And this is a new table. I've just got to concentrate now. And even if I'm not feeling great, it can all change really quickly in this game. Many people at this table, but the guy on the button is unfamiliar. I haven't played much against him. I'm looking down at Jack 7 after a limp from the button and a small blind call. I mean, are they folding just all the time if I jam here? That's too risky. Okay, I'll just put it in the middle, but I don't know why these situations. I kind of just want to jam from time to time. I'm like, they're never calling, but at the same time, I'm never too sure. If it was suited, I would have gone for it. All right, deuce, deuce, jack, it's not bad. I mean, I'm definitely the one with the most deuces here, so maybe I can play with that and start leading out with a bet here. I don't want my man on the bottom to free roll too much equity. Maybe with the way he plays against my bet, I can see something. All right, he's calling really quickly, so I'm kind of happy with that so far. I think he'd be calling a lot of ace highs quickly. Maybe a lot of pairs, probably fours, probably fives, if obviously calling. Now the turn is a 10. The thing is, I don't think I have three barrels value of my jack, because he could limp the jack queen, the jack king. Now, I think I'm gonna get a lot of information with this check. I don't think he's gonna bet twice any hand that is worse than me. He can bet once for protection quite a lot. Maybe he can even bet pocket fives, pocket sixes for protection. Maybe he's got a hand like queen nine, king queen that he didn't want to fold the flop. Now he's going to continue. I think it was just too hard for me to bet myself and to put myself in a guessing game river, so I prefer to check call here. The river's a king. I don't love it. He definitely has more kings than me. I just have the jack that splits now. against everything, but ace jack, king jack, jack 10, but he's obviously gonna bet with that. If he checks it back, I'm feeling pretty confident, at least a split. And jack 10, that's three pair, two pairs, jacks and 10, better than my jacks and deuces, yeah. Okay, I lose. All right, it's all good. Okay, back blind and blind. Looking down at 9-8 suited. I mean, he doesn't even have 20 blinds, 15, 16 blinds, it looks like. What is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm just going to go all in.
All in.
I always believe my opponents will be calling quite tight with my 30, 40 left. I mean, closer to 20 to 30 than to 40 now, and the stakes are getting high. I really like jamming these sort of hands. Probably jam quite wide on blind compared to most, but I'm happy with the strategy. Gets through. Come on. God, I'm running deep again in these tournaments. I mean, it's the third tournament in the week. The one that Alex won, I went deep. The other one, 20, 30 left. I'm just praying one thing now, is that I can break through this barrier of the 20, 30 players left this year. It's been tough for me. I haven't seen a semi-final on a final table yet. And I know the next half hour is going to be of enormous importance. But hey, it's the poker gods at the side. And my decisions. I tried to get that side the best I possibly can. But now jack 7 is playing 13 blinds. I think it's good enough again. Probably good enough again. I could limp, but I think the all-in with the big blind ante here, probably the best move. What if he says he's one lower than the last time, and last time he folded, even if he has less chips, should be a fold again.
Well, it was exactly the same one, and you weren't sure anymore.
Well, hopefully it was a call in the first place, so the one card lower is a call, he's making some errors, but I'll never know. Blinds are going up quickly here. It's ready 25, 50k. The min raise is 100k. Most players don't have too much space to play post flop, but this guy from the cutoff believes he does. Raising it to 100k. I'm looking down at ace 10 here. It's not the greatest hand in hold'em, but it's good for this sort of circumstance. I mean, he's from the cutoff. If he's got a lot of raise folds there, I mean, I'm already taking down 250,000 or something. Okay, he's got about 800 behind. Maybe he can raise fold quite a lot of hands. I'm gonna jam.
All in.
Oh, it's good, he hasn't called yet. I think he would have called even quicker. Ace jack. Yeah, he's gonna fold. That's brilliant. It really is brilliant when you get these 15 blind jams through on these moments where the average is just around 25 blind. I mean, they're so important. I'm feeling confident now, Already less than 30 left. I'm texting my mates, feeling good. Gonna put the phone back down, but every hand is so important here, paramount importance.
Alright,
it's back to me, same situation, bit kicking the last time. I'm just going to continue jamming him. He's starting to get annoyed now that I'm jamming every time. Oh, he's got an easy call this time, that's no good. What's he have? Ace 10, okay, I'm alive. I need a jack or 8 to be good, and no jack or 8 and I'll be back to 10 blinds, but hopefully my buddy over here, Louis, can do something. But he don't know, that's a straight on the turn, I'm drawing dead. Ah. Okay, well, it's bound to wake up with a hand at one moment, and well, that was an easy call for him, and I'm losing half my stack on this hand, but at the same time, it's the price to pay playing aggressively blind on blind with a big blind and he's in a 6 max. I'm pretty sure it's the right way to go, but now I'm extremely short stacked. But at the same time, on this tournament, it's okay. I mean, I've got these 10, 12 blinds, but the average isn't more than 30 blinds, so I can take my time, I can be patient, I can fall to 4 or 5 blinds even. I'll still have fold equity on players. That's what's unbelievable. I got to stay in this game. There's just been a few eliminations now, and I think there's a pay jump pretty soon. Got to keep my eye out for that. Players are playing a bit slowly here. It's folded around to me again. Okay, I've seen a good hand. It's really one of those situations you don't want to see like a 5 deuce or a 7-3. I've seen king 9. I can easily put in
that's a little less.
Small stack. That's all I've been doing is jamming blind on blind this day too. But okay, this one gets through and that's brilliant because it's about a third of my stack out there. Climbing back up to 10 blinds is good. I can wait a bit more, have that important double up spot, and go. It's tough here, I'm not seeing anything, and I'm really depending on the card the dealer gives me, and I've just gone through so many terrible hands. At the same time, a couple players getting knocked off. I can see now that we're being paid $15,000 right now. And the next pay jump is 24 players left at 19,000.
Easy, easy, man. Easy.
That's a good word, you know.
Easy. Be it's nice. A big part of your stack, 300K, man. Don't just give it up like that. I know you don't want to shove this hand, you know?
No, it didn't work. Let's see what I have.
Not terrible. I'm gonna have to go with this, I think. Aye, aye, aye.
What have I got? I've got 240 behind. That's 4 blinds, I think it's good enough. I don't like it, but I think I've got to put it in. King Jack, wow, okay. I wasn't expecting two and four offsuit, but I think I've been amazing enough hands. I've just got enough extra against the range. That's a really good flop. Okay, now just no paint and I'm good. No paint, dealer. Come on, we can get back into this. Yes, come on. All right. Even if it's these small double ups, the 26, 27 left, I mean, it's so important. It's from getting out of the tournament to staying with a life in the game we love, so close to the moment we've been waiting for. Just a few more like that, dude, that's brilliant. A little bit of breathing space.
I told you you didn't want to shove.
Nah, I hate being that guy that laughs with the guy that just lost the pot, but he's a good buddy. I mean, he's someone I talk to from time to time, so it's all good. I wouldn't do it to someone I don't know at all. One more eliminated that wins $15,000 and then everyone wins 19 and we have to wait until like 16th or something to win more. So like the 16th and the 24th win the same amount of money. And we're one away from that spot. It's important for me to realise these things because, well, it's more than a buy-in. It is important. And wow, he's raised here 140,000, but he doesn't even have 10 blinds to stop the hand. See what I have. Pocket fives. Wow, it's a big hand.
475.
475 behind? And you raise to 140.
Yeah, 140.
Okay, so if he's jamming, I'm probably definitely calling, but what is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 500 behind. He's got about 10 blinds total. He's coming with a raise. I mean, it's not even a min raise, it's a bit more. I mean, there's so many arguments going in every side here, but I'm very happy to take a lot of time because there's exactly 25 players left and we're really one from the bubble. Well, not really the bubble, but just the pay jump, so I'm happy to take my time. What is he doing here? Why is he not jamming? Is there any hands that he's raised folding this stack? Does he just have aces or kings and I can get away from it? I don't know, it doesn't. I'm just not sure about this one. If he's never folding, it's probably smarter for me to just fold and take the $4,000 extra from the next guy busting out and hoping I get into a better spot afterwards. But if he folds from time to time, I mean, what I can gain on my stack is insane. There's only half my stack out there. I'm a bit lost here, but it's fine. I take my time because time is free and the decisions are not really easy. This thing never happens in poker tournaments. 25 left. What do I do? Does he just have aces and kings?
Sorry, 475 behind, right? And 140.
People at my table must be like, what's all this time he's taking here? But it's a really tough decision and I could benefit from the fact from someone else busting. For sure, if someone else busts, I go all in. This is no question. People must just think I'm stalling here. And they realize there's a pay jump and they think I probably just have jack four off soon. I'm taking my time. I'm just going to wait the longest possible here. If someone times me and no one's gone all in, maybe I just fold because I think they could just have a hand that he's never folding.
4-1-0.
The clock has been called on me. I've probably got about a minute, 30 seconds left.
Is that enough time to act?
Yes.
All right, sir, you're on the clock after 25 seconds. I'll give you a 5-second count off. If you've not acted on your hand by the time I say zero, your hand's dead.
I hear player all in behind me on the table. Oh my God, on Matas' table, someone's gone all in. And the clock's ticking against me here. Just tell me there's a bust out. Tell me there's a bust out, I can go all in. Oh my god, what's going on? 10 seconds and they're still not in the table. The boards are going on.
5, 4, 3.
Oh, and the player's going off. I think there's been a bust out. I've got to go all in. Wow, there's been a bust out of the other table just now with 24 left. That means whatever happens, I get the pay jump for $19,000 and my opponent hasn't even called yet. Wow, everything just went incredibly good in the last 5 seconds there. I took my time, but it was brilliant because from maybe 1 second or 2 seconds in it, the guy busted. 25th, so we're 24 left and he hasn't even called my 9-blind shove yet. He's put more than 2 blinds out there and he's just got about 9 blinds as well. This is incredible. Now the payouts here, he should really call any single hand he has. He's going to be at least flipping most of the time, but oh, I couldn't give it away. That would just be absolutely insane. Wow, he's giving it away. That is brilliant for me. Wow, what a win. Half my stack and we've got the pay junk. So that is a very, very positive couple of seconds. I've still only got 15 blinds, but it feels like
the clock like exactly the right time. Right 2 seconds before, I'm not sure I jam. That's okay, it's okay, it's okay. It's fine. Did I get cards? Oh, yeah, sorry.
Just in time.
Good luck, guys. If you have more than a full rack, please leave them in the rack and then provide your
food. I'm a small blind, right?
Everything's in front of us.
Oh, yes. Raising
the big line.
Yeah. Out of pair. Huh? Out of pair.
All in.
All right, all in from the cutoff here. I'm looking down at ace, nine off. Okay, how much does he have? He's quite 8 blinds. Okay, this is definitely a call. It's quite a good spot for me. He has loads of aces that I dominate. He's got other hands. I just have to take this one from the button. Even if ace nine is not unbelievable, they're going to be calling too tight in the blinds as well. Yeah, we're both all in, sir. Wow, he folds 9-10 suited. Probably had a good spot to call here. An ace 3, okay, that's great. Okay, I'm dominating his 3 of my 9. I just need to avoid a 3 and I'll be really good here. Come on. Alright, that's not bad. Just no 3. Oh no, he's just hit the turn. I can't believe it.
I'll take that.
Okay, split pot. Wow, these poker emotions. Unbelievable. Up and down. 1 second you're here, the other second you're there. Heading to the split pot against my buddy over here, and it's all right. We don't lose everything we're going to lose on the turn. Skills here.
Yeah, it's a break.
Please play forever.
Yeah, 5.2.
What a fucking player, this guy. Try to tilt him, it can't work. It can't work. The guy is just a legend. Just a legend.
He's a legend.
Doing well? Doing well. Hopefully, man, hopefully. God, man, 5.2 million on this average means, like, without you, the average chips is like
it's insane. It's a good spot to be in.
It's not bad.
But you know, it's turbo. It's like 1-2 double up, that's it.
It's insane turbo.
The chip leader had like 3 million at the beginning of the day. Now he has like 1.2, I guess.
Yeah. Now he has 5.2.
Exactly.
The chip leader always is chip leader.
Yeah. It's fun.
Fun.
Yeah, it was a long day yesterday, and we started playing the same table at the very start of this tournament. And now we're both stood in, he's got a humongous chip stack. And probably a favourite for the tournament right now, Matas, a really great player. But the most important is for me to concentrate on my decisions right now, and I'll hopefully join him in the final table later.
to have it fairly frequently. Yeah. That just comes with the territory.
So if I'm dead, I'd be surprised.
It's a nice day. It's a shame.
Guys, a little more to
I seem to recall having a fun time.
Yeah.
A lot of people told me I had a fun time.
40-80. Dealers, go to work.
Go to work.
No, it's the player on the gun here. Looks like he probably wants to move all in. He's playing the ante big blind next hand and he's got so little chips. It's one of those situations where you're like, do I go all in with this hand or do I go all in any hand next hand? And he's deciding to go all in this hand. I mean, the blinds are 80k. That means next hand it would have, 160k would have gone out. So I think he can go in. I'm going to have to go all in here with Jack 10. I think it's good enough. I mean, he's going to have so many jacks that are worse, so many tens that are worse, and I have so little playability of my stack. I've got to take the situations when I can. I think the people in the blinds are going to be folding two stronger hands as well. I mean, it's only four blind shove and a seven blind reshove, but they'll fold stronger holdings. And he's got king queen. It's definitely not what I wanted to see. I would have preferred a jack 9 or a 10-9, but I can still get there. I'm not dominated. Now, come on, put a jack out there. Put a 10 out there. Do it for me, dealer. All right, well, I did say I was losing the small ones and winning the big ones, but now I definitely need to win the next ones, even how small they possibly are. Don't have much time left here to pick hands and pick situations. I've got to be pretty aggressive in my choices if I stand a chance in this tournament. It's a shame I didn't win one of the last two hands, but hey. It's poker, folks. Come on. All right, he's going for the raise, and I look down here, and I've got ace-queen, so... yeah, I'm just looking again, and it's all good. It's ace-queen. I'm definitely getting called here. It's one of the best holdings in poker. Hopefully he has an ace or a queen as well, and I can get it in really favorite, but... he's never folding his. He's come back up to about a million chips. A bit less. Hopefully the big blind folds, that we can play for all that money for free. These are tough, these situations. Okay, here we go. Okay, ace nine, perfect. That's all I want. Get back up to 12 blinds, just no 9. Oh my god, that's a 9, I see. I had to queen now, a queen or I'm out of the tournament. Fuck.
Okay, guys.
It's all over. It's 23rd again. It's been a tough week. I mean, the deep runs have been good, it's been fun, I've had fun playing, I think my decisions have been okay, but. It's frustrating, it's just all over like that. You're in the game, you're in the tournament. Poker's part of my life, big part of my life. And the last 2 days, it was all of my life, and it stops again, 23rd place.
Good luck, guys. Yeah. Cool.
Can you just go up here, please?
Yeah.
Your ID and your poker.
Brilliant, thank you very much.
I mean, it's... these moments that are tough that make the brilliant moments so good and make the wins the ones we wait for, but I just hope there won't be too many 20th places in a row before the big moment. The feeling is quite frustrating again here, but I've got to keep my head up, I've got to keep my chin up. It's the only way to keep going in this world, and especially in this poker world. I mean, it's been a tough week, but at the same time, 223rd places and 135th or something. I mean, Alex showed me the way. He showed me the way, and I'm sure I can do it. I'm sure I can get there one day. I'm sure I can bring this bracelet home. It's just, when is the question? When?
You're right, Romain. You have to find the positive aspects to defeat. transform the disappointment into an additional motivation to do even better the next time. And that's exactly what you did during the 2021 World Series of Poker. Because 3 weeks later, your fifth World Championship final table was the one, and it was in possession of a bracelet and over $450,000 that you left Las Vegas after a world-class performance in the $10,000 Super Turbo Bounty Tournament against the likes of Dario Sammartino, Stephen Chedwick, and Yevgeny Timoshenko. An unforgettable victory, which at the age of 26 definitely puts you in the big leagues. Romain's adventures at the World Series end here, but not for us, rest assured. We'll be looking at another prestigious tournament and another Team Winamax Pro. You'll find out soon enough in the next episode of Inside the Mind of a Pro.